jump right into the set. So Mennonite versus Bayonetta, both characters have a very atrocious neutral. Bayonetta especially did get the nerfs, but because of the nerfs Mennonite got too, they're about even they're even playing ground for that neutral game. But I believe Bayonetta would get a lot more leverage off of her punishes than Mennonite at this point. Bayonetta isn't in the range to get scooped anymore. I know Mennonite does get it still on floaty characters, but Bayonetta's not one of them. And just that especially that down tilt will really give Mennonite some trouble. Nice follow-up. Get some nair too. See, Mennonite's gonna have a hard time just getting in as well, because that sword just doesn't... Her legs outrange that sword. Oh, very nice. He lands the up air and then just stops dead in the center of that up air string and goes for the forward attack. Works out really well for him, and it takes the momentum and puts it in his favor. Okay. White House fishing for that up B. I don't agree with the way his stance is right now, because what's going on is he's turning his back to Mennonite, so he's completely like... I can't think of the word right now, but basically he's telling Hiwi, hey, I'm about to back air you. You better get ready for it. See what he's gonna do. Hiwi just respecting his movement. Hey guys, we have some crazy fish on the mic as well. So right now this is game one, talk one basically. Yeah, this Mikey said this is a rematch with Caddy apparently. I don't know who won there though. Ooh.
I think it was
Whiteout.
They got top eight.
Yeah, probably. Okay, nice back air, but ooh. You know, from seeing JVAndrew all the time do that, I always expect the hit second hit. It's one of those moves that Mennonite has that's weird, because you have to respect it all the time.
Otherwise, you pay really hard.
Yeah, so you gotta respect it and just not punish him out of it. It's a 50-50 if you don't. If he doesn't do it. Anyway, he does a good job taking that first stock from Whiteout. Okay, here we go. Back air. Nice. Yeah. Bale's got plenty, like, she has
lots of combos.
She has hella combos.
She has death.
Yeah, which is fine. That's
healthy.
That's it. Boom, you're out of here. Pee-wee. Yeah, that was really good, yeah. Good job on Whiteout with that, sipping off that setup. Was he trying to smash? I definitely saw the smash symbol. Oh man, I can't wait to fight this character all the time. Phaser match. Wait, when he picks him up more? When he commits to playing Bayo against me? I can't wait.
No, people like, Bayo doesn't do well against
Sonic, like, SP thinks he beats him. Yeah, no, she did before. Now probably Sonic's favorite, just because all Sonic has to do is something new. Okay, he's against side B? Side pole.
Too early.
He needed to give it a little few more seconds. Okay, trying for down here. I think he would actually kill Mennonite. He would kill Mennonite, because he has a little bit of rage, and Mennonite's up to 9. This matchup is just like hard for Mennonite, because like before Mennonite's nerfs, he can kill her off a hit, and now he has to like commit to really slow moving attacks, get any leverage on her. And her down tilt, even though it got the range nerf, it still ranges his sword. Her legs still range his sword at most in the air and on the ground.
So.
Oh wow. Yeah, I'm surprised it was a punish. Okay, yeah, he's doing the JVAndrew. Here comes a back throw.
Just
bring out the guns, big guns. Oh, very dangerous up there. He could have, if TV met a little more patience. See, that's what I'm saying. Like, you have to respect it, because if you commit to punishing it and it's actually an attack, you die.
You die.
You die. And it's like. No. I think he sniffed it out. He just, yeah, just missed. That's it. Good job on Whiteout. That second stock was definitely the cleanest right there. I was at TDG8 this weekend, and Captain Zach got fourth, I believe, of Bayonetta. That dude uses a lot of wish time. Like, he'll use it when you only have like a half second of wish time, and he'll just down tilt you once and then just start the combo from there. Like, it would make sense, because like, as long as you wish time them at all, then you get the hit, but you get at least one free hit. You get one free hit, and down tilt's like the best move. Arguably her best move besides Wish Time. That nonsense will murder you. You'll just get like 0 to 50 after that. Here comes up tilt, up there, oh, nair. Just going for the nair to back air again. It's gonna be a lot. I think you should go for like down tilt
I think like, yeah, like down tilt, up air into up. I think like either like another up air or up B into the side Bs. Pretty easy to control that. You also know how to DI that well. And yeah, no, like yeah, that's really dangerous. Like after you get the side Bs, because the way how easy it is to DI it now, it's better to just get the two side Bs and then back off. Just get to the ground because you'll be there first, and then you can camp them on the ledge. Having said that, but this actually, the wall,
the fallout,
the moist floor smash. It's perfect. Nice up there. See.
Now Lucario is character of pants and leaving straight. He's behind.
Well, the issue right now is that like, basically Lucario's not playing the game right now. He has to wait till 70% to play the game, and that kills him because of that raid. Yeah, definitely. Oh, don't no. Come on, not the BM. Please. The BM, dude. Here comes a... Yeah. There it is. Another one. Back here. That was bro. Yeah, see, you know, Lucario was like, a good take on paper. It's just that second stock was unfortunate, and then he walked into a forward smash. But it just... I hope this doesn't discourage him from taking Lucario in the future. It's just... That didn't go well.
The fans are pretty hard. Not really have much...
Because neutral. However, that and he's challenged Bayonetta too much. Instead of just holding shield and grabbing him a lot. Now this is the dangerous part about Lucario. If Bayonetta's trying to grab her witch time, she could easily die to Lucario at like 40 off the ledge. Four tilt, back air.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'll go say like, what are you doing? Yeah. Not yet. Lucario's almost at max aura.
Lucario's almost at optimal Lucario percent.
I think Lucario's max aura is at like
150.
150? I remember in Brawl, it used to be 180, I think. 170. Yeah. That's it. I was thinking he could either do all that. He tried challenging with forward smash. Didn't want to. Yeah, Whiteout did pick up Bayonetta a little bit after her release, but he stopped playing her because she was like broken, I guess, and he didn't like it. But now that she's like a little more healthy, she's still